So when we hear the howling in the cities, is there any chance that one of the howls that we hear might be a coyote when we're outside doing it ourselves?
Yeah, absolutely. I think certainly coyotes and wolves, if you play a siren or if you howl, they'll respond if they're near. So I know a number of people that have reported, doing this howling at 8 o'clock and having a pack of coyotes respond. And when I was doing work in Denver, we'd have an emergency vehicle pass by, and I'd always wait to listen for coyote howls. So they respond to that a lot. And so it's the same in this situation. They start hearing people howling, and they'll definitely respond.
We're missing our daily routines where we interact with other human beings. We are missing our regular routines where we commune with people, regardless of what that looks like, if it's live music nights or religion. And then we're missing our special community rituals around these events, especially in the face, of trauma or sadness or grief. So we're
Yeah.
missing all three of those. And we need them both for joy and for grief, right? So if you
Yeah.
think about all of the communal things, we need that collective experience. But the howling carries, importantly, it carries over long distance.
That's really cool.
And people, you are able to like hear the call and response to bring back together that communality. And it does that kind of magical thing of giving people the opportunity both to express grief and also an expression of communal joy.